हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल। टॉपिक ऑफ माय प्रेजेंटेशन इज रिजर्वायर फिशरीज ऑफ इंडिया। फ्रेंड्स, रिजर्वायर्स आर द आर्टिफिशियल इम्पाउंडमेंट कंस्ट्रक्टेड अक्रॉस रिवर और स्ट्रीम फॉर इरिगेशन, हाइड्रो पावर जनरेशन एंड फ्लड कंट्रोल। इन इंडिया reservoirs are classified on the basis of watershed area. Large reservoirs are with more than 5000 hectare area of water. Medium reservoirs are with 1000 to 5000 hectare of watershed area, and small reservoirs are those which are having less than 1000 hectare of watershed area. As far as reservoir area is concerned, according to Indian Institute of Management, Ahmedabad, India has 975 reservoirs with combined area of 1.7 million hectare. Sugunan mentions that our country has 3 million hectare of reservoir area and it will double by 2025. Shetty is of the opinion that 3 million hectare area in our country, it contribute to about 50% of Southeast Asian reservoirs. Before starting reservoir fisheries and its management, let me come to effects of dams. Benthic riverine fauna disappears and replaced by lacustrine benthic fauna. Riverine plankton replaced by lacustrine plankton. Turbidity level reduced as reservoirs act as settling basins. Fish fauna is greatly affected. Running water species become fewer or eliminated, and slow water fish species become predominant. Discharge of sediments from reservoirs may cause mud and silting in lower reaches. Plankton increases in lower reaches due to drift from reservoir. Mud and silting in the lower reaches with serious consequences upon the fauna. As far as effect on fish and fisheries are concerned, few resident species like Notopterus, Channa, Master Cymbalus and Gara species have no adverse effect. They stay comfortably in this environment. Short distance species like Mahasheer means Tor Kudri, Tor Putitora, Tor Mosel, Indian major carps and few catfishes are badly affected. The migratory fishes like Angula Angula and Hilsa are also badly affected. As I told that Hilsa Elisa, which is a anadromous migratory fish which migrates from seawater to riverine water, so fishery of Hilsa is also badly affected after construction of reservoirs, anicuts and barrages. Similarly, fishery of eels is also affected as it is a migratory fish. So this is a list of some important large reservoirs in our country from different states. Mettur, Bhavani Sagar and Stanley, these three reservoirs are from state of Tamil Nadu. Tungabhadra, Himavati and Krishnaraj Sagar Reservoir from Karnataka. Nagarjuna Sagar Reservoir, which was constructed across the river Krishna, is from Andhra Pradesh. Hirakud, which is the largest earthen dam constructed across the river Mahanadi, is from Orissa. Rihand and Nanak Sagar, these two reservoirs are from Uttar Pradesh. And Goind Sagar and Pong, these two reservoirs are important from state of Himachal Pradesh. Now let me come to reservoir fisheries management. To obtain high production of fish, scientific reservoir fisheries management is essential. The annual average fish yield of Indian reservoir is around 15 to 20 kg per hectare per year, and this yield can be raised up to 50 kg per hectare per year. The reservoir fisheries management can be studied under different heads as described below. Let me come to pre-impoundment management. It includes the clearing of the proposed area of submergence, of forest trees and other obstructions like boulders and buildings. These obstructions can easily damage the fishing nets. Submerged dense jungles and boulders provide good hideouts of fish. All this results in the net loss of fish production. After removal of obstructions, next aspect in pre-impoundment management is information on fish fauna. It is very essential to collect sufficient information on fish species present in the river stretch above the proposed dam site. The information is very much desirable for formulating future stocking policies. Location of fish breeding site. This is also an important aspect in pre-impoundment management. For estimation of productivity of reservoir and for adopting suitable stocking policies, the study of water quality of reservoir water is of great importance. And to facilitate the migration of fishes to their breeding and feeding grounds upstream of the dam and vice versa, it is necessary to provide the fishways or fish ladders at the time of construction of dam. To stock reservoir with quality fish seed, it is essential to construct a fish hatchery in the vicinity of reservoir, which would cut down transportation charges and can provide quality fish seed of carps. And lastly, it has been found that there is a loss of fish which escape from sluice gates of the reservoir. To prevent escaping of fishes, the use of screens is necessary. Now, after pre-impoundment management, let me come to post-impoundment management. It includes study of natural productivity of water. It comprises information on physicochemical properties of water, plankton study, and seasonal water levels. After this, next important management aspect is seed stocking and stocking rate. The reservoir should be stocked with large-sized fingerlings of 100 to 150 millimeter size. Fingerlings of different species should be stocked in the reservoir. Indian Institute of Management, Ahmedabad, suggested the stocking of fingerlings as below. So, large reservoirs should be stocked at the rate of 200 fingerlings per hectare. Medium reservoirs should be stocked at the rate of 400 fingerlings per hectare. And small reservoirs should be stocked at the rate of 1000 fingerlings per hectare. So, this is about seed stocking rate in different categories of reservoirs. And the last aspect is reservoir administration and management, which includes fishing policy, mesh regulation, control of reservoir and declaration of closed season. We know that Indian major carps and other fishes breed during monsoon season, that is from June to September, and this period when fish breed is generally observed as the closed season in respect of the most of the Indian reservoirs, and during this period fishing should be prohibited. Similarly, poaching, then pollution in reservoirs, these are also important management aspects. So, fishermen should be trained and socio-economic status of fishermen should be studied. Now, let me come to last aspect of this presentation, that is performance of exotic fishes in Indian fish fauna. In post-independence period, so many foreign species were stocked in Indian reservoirs for aquaculture purpose. Let me come to first foreign or exotic fish, which is Tilapia mozambica. It is native of Africa and Middle East. It is farmed in more than 90 countries and cultured in freshwater ponds and reservoirs of Java, Malaysia, Thailand, India, Pakistan, South Africa, Uganda, Zambia, and the backwaters of Indonesia, Malaysia, India, and Pakistan. Some tilapia species can adapt to full strength of seawater also. The nickname aquatic chicken has been used on tilapia due to its availability to grow quickly with poor quality inputs. In India, the first consignment of tilapia was brought by CMFRI on August of 1952 from Bangkok, and the second by Madras Fisheries Department in the same year. Tilapia is hardy but displays some of the most undesirable characters. It bears at a very small size, and it is difficult to grow to a reasonable market size with huge differences in growth between the sexes. Due to all these characteristics, tilapias are referred as weed fish. Friends, the introductions of tilapia into Indian waters have not been a very happy experience. It has adversely affected the indigenous gene pool. In Pavai Lake of Mumbai, the major carps have been badly hit with the accidental introduction of tilapia. Similarly, in Jaisman Lake of Udaipur, where the carp fishery has totally collapsed after entry of tilapia. In Amravati Reservoir of Tamil Nadu, tilapia forms about 90% of the catch. Similarly, in Krishnagiri Reservoir, tilapia contribute to 69% of the total catch. In Vaigai Reservoir, tilapia is the single largest component of fishery which has eliminated Indian major carps. In Upper Reservoir, tilapia's contribution was 58 and the major carp share was 33 in year 1989. In Pampa Reservoir, percentage of fish yield obtained from tilapia population was the highest. Similarly, Chuliyar, Minkara, Pichi and Malampuzha reservoirs in Kerala were stocked with tilapia in early 60s, and presently the fish contributes substantially in the catch. In Malampuzha reservoir, tilapia forms 70% of the total catch. One of my students, he has completed his PhD in Borna reservoir near Parali Vaidyanath of Maharashtra. And in this reservoir particularly, tilapia has nearly eliminated katla, and it contributes to about 45% of the total fish catch in the reservoir. It never grow more than 250 grams, and local consumers, they mostly prefer Indian major carps and catfishes, not tilapia. Next fish is silver carp, Hypophthalmites molitrix. It naturally occurs in rivers by South and Central China. It is one of the Chinese major carp and has introduced in Indian waters in 1959 for aquaculture purpose. Karamchandani and Mishra observed that silver carp hampered the growth of katla in several Indian reservoirs. Accidental entry of silver carp formed a breeding population in Goind Sagar Reservoir of Himachal Pradesh and Kulgiri Reservoir of Madhya Pradesh. These reservoirs were known for dominance of katla fishery, whereas the invasion of silver carp altered the habitat, rendering it suitable for sustaining katla. Fishery of katla and torp putitora in Goind Sagar Reservoir of Himachal Pradesh has been drastically curtailed by the entry of silver carp. Next to silver carp, next exotic fish is common carp, Cyprinus carpio. It is a bottom feeder, omnivorous, and it feeds on vegetable debris, insects, worms, crustaceans and planktonic algae. It is not suitable for stocking in Indian reservoirs. This fish has now escaped into rivers and presently populating the entire stretch of River Yamuna and Gomti. Introduction of common carp in India is reported to have caused a sharp decline in the commercial catches of endemic schizothoracids. This fish is also found in River Godavari, Kaveri, Krishna, Tapi and Mahanadi. It has not only the potential to hybridize with Rohu, Katla and Mrigal, but can easily breed with goldfish also. Sehgal reported that common carp catches from Goind Sagar Reservoir and Pong Reservoir are gaining predominance over the Mashir and schizothoracids. In Manipur, common carp displaced the Osteobroma belangeri from Loktuk Lake. Next fish is Clarius garipinus, which is commonly known as Thai Magur or African Magur. This fish has seriously threatened the existence of local Magur, that is Clarius batrachus. Recently, Clarius garipinus had got entry in some reservoirs and rivers like Ganga, Yamuna, Satluj and Godavari. African catfish in Bangladesh has been reported to deplete 56 fish species. However, such claims are now made in India as well. Because of great damage to the environment and biodiversity, the government of India has banned this fish. Friends, for further readings, you can refer Reservoir Fisheries of India, this FAO report written by Dr. V.V. Sugnan, which was published in 1996. By Daya Publishing House, Delhi. Next title is Reservoir Fisheries and Limnology, authored by V.B. Sakre, published by Narendra Publishing House, Delhi in 2007. And third title, Fish and Fisheries of Indian Reservoirs, authored by V.B. Sakre, published by Astral International Private Limited, New Delhi in 2015. Thank you.